What if I told you the future of flight is already here, and it's faster than you ever imagined? In today's episode, we dive deep into the forefront of aerospace innovation to unravel the secrets of the SR-72, a potential marvel in modern aviation technology that might just redefine the boundaries of speed and stealth. The SR-72 is not just any aircraft. It represents a leap forward from its legendary predecessor, the SR-71 Blackbird. This new contender is rumored to be equipped with cutting-edge stealth capabilities and revolutionary propulsion technology that could allow it to outpace and outmaneuver the most sophisticated aerial defenses. It embodies decades of aerospace development and hushed progress, hinting at a future where high-speed reconnaissance achieves unprecedented levels. As we sift through the layers of secrecy and speculation, the SR-72 emerges as a potential game-changer in the realm of military technology. From whispers of its existence to the tangible technological breakthroughs that could make such an aircraft feasible, join me in piecing together how this aircraft could dramatically alter our understanding of aerial warfare. Together, let's explore the edge of aerospace capabilities, where the SR-72 could very well dominate the skies. The program's early days, back in the 1980s, as the iconic SR-71 Blackbird neared its retirement in 1989, rumors began circulating about a successor that would surpass its capabilities. Skepticism arose about retiring such a legendary aircraft without a formidable replacement ready. Speculation swirled about a new advanced spy plane capable of achieving higher speeds and altitudes, possibly hidden within the US's classified projects. Despite hints at projects like Aurora, no clear successor emerged immediately after the Blackbird's retirement, fueling curiosity and speculation. The anticipation for this next-generation aircraft was akin to the tech industry's leap from flip phones to smartphones. But with the national security and aerospace technology at stake, this intense curiosity and the swirling rumors continued to stoke interest, leaving everyone wondering what kind of futuristic bird of prey the US was developing, capable of dominating the skies with unprecedented speed and altitude. The revival and initial design work. After the SR-71 Blackbird was retired in 1989, it experienced several revivals, being brought into service in 1994 and retiring again in 1999, with another brief revival attempt in 2001. This indicated that no other spy plane available could match its capabilities at the time. Meanwhile, Lockheed Martin was not just sitting back, they were actively supporting U-2 operations and advancing projects like the RQ-170, but they also saw a golden opportunity to innovate further. By 2006, Lockheed Martin had moved deep into the design phase for a hypersonic aircraft that aimed to surpass the Blackbird. This new project wasn't merely an upgrade, it was a leap forward, aiming to redefine the limits of aerospace technology. As they brainstormed and sketched out their visions, they set the stage for what would be a revolutionary step in aerial reconnaissance and defense, marking the beginning of a new era in high-speed aviation. Lockheed Martin's media push in 2013. By 2013, after 7 years of development shrouded in secrecy, Lockheed Martin was ready to unveil their advanced hypersonic project. Hypersonic program manager Brad Leland took center stage, announcing their plans and becoming the spokesperson for what was once a covert endeavor. He detailed an ambitious timeline, aiming to reveal a single-engine technology demonstrator by 2018 or 2019, a significant reveal funded entirely by Lockheed Martin's resources. The announcement generated immense buzz within the aerospace community and beyond. After years of quiet speculation, Lockheed Martin was now setting concrete deadlines and discussing prototypes. This shift from mere conceptual discussions to tangible plans marked a significant moment, signaling that their hypersonic project was moving from the realm of possibilities into reality, capturing global attention and reshaping expectations in the aerospace industry. The hypersonic engine development Lockheed Martin recognized that achieving true hypersonic speeds required more than an advanced airframe. It demanded an engine capable of extraordinary performance. This led to their collaboration with Aerojet Rocketdyne to develop a turbine-based combined cycle engine. Simplifying this, imagine a standard turbofan engine used for takeoff and landing paired with a scramjet that activates at hypersonic speeds, essentially combining two engines in one for seamless transitions from subsonic to hypersonic travel. Their ambitious target is Mach 6, a speed that would revolutionize aerial capabilities. Moreover, there are whispers that this engine might push boundaries even further, potentially setting new records for speed and efficiency. This venture isn't just about achieving high speeds, but is aimed at fundamentally transforming the future of aerial technology, with Lockheed Martin and Aerojet Rocketdyne at the forefront of this pioneering endeavor. Material challenges and innovations. Reaching Mach 6 introduces formidable material challenges, as flying at such speeds drastically elevates operational temperatures. For perspective, while the SR-71 Blackbird contended with temperatures around 900 degrees Fahrenheit at its operational speeds, the new hypersonic project faces temperatures up to an extreme 3,500 degrees Fahrenheit. Addressing this, Lockheed Martin innovated beyond traditional methods by developing pyromanium, a cutting-edge composite blending ceramics and carbon-based materials designed to withstand these severe conditions without compromising structural integrity. This breakthrough isn't just an advancement, it's a revolution in material science within aerospace engineering. Pyromanium enables not only higher speeds, but also reshapes the entire approach to designing aircraft capable of enduring such extremes. With this innovative material, Lockheed Martin is not only equipped to achieve unprecedented speeds, but also altering the fundamental principles of aerospace design, setting a robust foundation for future developments in hypersonic travel. DARPA and NASA involvement. In 2014, the development of Lockheed Martin's hypersonic project gained monumental support as DARPA and NASA joined the effort alongside aerospace giants like Boeing and Northrop Grumman. This collaboration marked a significant shift, transforming the venture into a robust competition of aerospace innovation and engineering. Despite a period of public silence from Lockheed Martin about the project, significant advancements were being made behind the scenes. In 2021, a major breakthrough occurred when Aerojet Rocketdyne successfully tested their combined cycle engine, a critical component for achieving unprecedented speeds, marking a pivotal moment in hypersonic technology development. The intrigue surrounding the project intensified over the years. By 2017, Lockheed Martin's vice president, Jack O'Banion, was openly discussing how digital advancements were propelling the project forward, notably in areas like engine technology and materials such as pyromanium, which could endure extreme heat. Rumors even suggested that by 2020, a full-scale demonstrator might have already been tested in secrecy, pushing the limits of current aerospace capabilities. Though official confirmation remains elusive, the ongoing speculation and unverified reports continue to stoke public interest and anticipation, highlighting the mysterious and highly anticipated potential of this hypersonic aircraft. In conclusion, the SR-72 project continues to operate under a veil of secrecy, but the clues are there. From its long development timeline to breakthroughs in hypersonic technology, all signs point to its reality and ongoing progress. Whether it's silently soaring through the skies or undergoing rigorous testing, the SR-72 symbolizes a remarkable advancement in aviation. This isn't just about building a faster plane, it's about rewriting the playbook for military capabilities in the 21st century. The implications are immense. From reconnaissance missions to defense strategies that could reshape global security, the SR-72 isn't just a plane, it's a testament to human ingenuity and our relentless pursuit of pushing boundaries. As we eagerly await more concrete details, one thing is clear: the SR-72 represents the future of aviation and beyond. Its legacy will be felt not just in the skies, but in the geopolitical landscape for years to come. Keep your eyes on the horizon because the story of the SR-72 is far from over. It's just getting started. Let us know what you think in the comments section below, and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. And to watch the latest updates, watch this video here.